안녕하세요 여러분, DBS 생활영어의 선현우입니다. 반갑습니다.
안녕하세요 여러분, and welcome back to another episode of EBS 생활영어. I'm Megan Bowen.
안녕하세요, 안녕하세요.
안녕하십니까?
Thank you for saying yes to another week with me.
I should have said no. I knew it.
네. Say yes, say no. 반대되는 개념이죠. Say yes, yes 하면은 네라고 말하다, 승낙하다. Say no, no 하면 거절하다는 뜻입니다. Mm-hmm. 이번 주의 주제는 saying no예요. 거절하는 것과 관련된 이야기를 한 주 동안 들어볼 건데요.
Alright.
오늘의 핵심 내용 준비했습니다.
Perfect. We're going to be talking about this in particular today. Saying no can be good for your mental health.
네, 거절하는 것은 can be good, 좋을 수 있습니다. For your mental health. 정신 건강에 좋을 수 있습니다. Which is absolutely true.
Yes, especially when you need to take a break, mm-hmm. right? Perfect. And today we have a clip sent to us by Sarah, who's from Australia.
Yeah, and Sarah has sent us a clip with a beautiful background, beautiful backdrop from Jeju Island, I believe. 틀릴 수도 있는데 아마 맞을 거예요.
Alright.
자, 그럼 사라 씨의 그 요약 문장부터 만나볼까요?
Okay, 사라 씨, 나와주세요.
I think it's really important to say no sometimes just for your mental health. I think it's really important to say no sometimes just for your mental health. I think it's really important to say no sometimes just for your mental health.
네, 사라 씨가 뭐가 중요하다고 말하고 있는지 다시 한번 보겠습니다.
So Sarah said, I think it's really important to say no sometimes just for your mental health.
네. I think it's really important 라고 했죠. 정말 중요한 것 같습니다. To say no sometimes, mm-hmm. 가끔씩은 거절하는 것이 just for your mental health. Mm-hmm. 다른 거, 다른 이유들이 아니고 mm-hmm. 정신 건강을 위해서라도 mm-hmm. 가끔씩은 거절하는 것이 정말 중요하다고 생각합니다. Yep. 라는 말이었어요. Mm-hmm. 이 문장을 다시 볼까요?
Let's review.
I think it's really important to say no sometimes just for your mental health. I think it's really important to say no sometimes just for your mental health. I think it's really important to say no sometimes just for your mental health.
Great, let's jump right into English
on the go.
It's time for English on the Go, so we're going to take a look at Sarah's full clip where she talks to us about how it's really important for your mental health to say no sometimes, especially when we take on too much, we can feel overwhelmed and get burnt out. Let's not let that happen. Let's see what else she has to say.
Just wanna ignite ya!
Are you ready? Go!
In this day and age, people feel so compelled to say yes to every single opportunity that they're given. And while that's a good thing, being open-minded and wanting to say yes, I also think that it's okay to say no sometimes for your own mental health. Because if you are always overbooking everything and just trying to take every opportunity you can, it can be mentally tiring and you end up getting burnt out. I see that with a lot of my friends who make online videos, that they just put way too much on their plate and get overwhelmed and then sort of end up just stopping and doing nothing for a little while. And so for me personally, instead of that, I think it's better to take things at a manageable pace and try and sort of regulate it so you can always do it. And that means sometimes you have to say no to stuff, and that's okay.
네, 이야기 잘 들어보셨죠? 오늘의 핵심 어휘 보고 공부 이어가겠습니다. 먼저 강요하다, 강제하다, compel 쓰였고요. 그 다음으로 예약을 초과해서 하다, overbook. book 자체가 예약하다라는 뜻이잖아요. booking 한다고 하죠. 그래서 overbooking 되어 있는 형태, overbook 동사로 쓰이고 있습니다. 그래서 만약 그거를 과거 분사로 쓰고 싶으면 it's overbooked가 되겠죠. 발음 연습을 하고 올까요?
Repeat after me, starting with compel. Compel, compel, overbook, overbook, overbook. Perfect. Let's look at a few more words.
그 다음으로 감당할 수 있는 manage. 보통 매니저가 하는 일 관리하는 거잖아요. manage가 관리하다는 뜻도 있지만 manage 하면 또 감당한다는 뜻도 있어요. I can manage 하면 저 혼자서 할 수 있어요 정도인데요. manageable 해서 감당할 만한, 감당할 수 있는 정도의란 뜻을 갖게 됩니다. 그리고 마지막으로 regulate, 규제하다, 조절하다. 여기 오늘 이야기 속 문맥에서는 규제까지는 아니고요. 어떤 제도 면의 규제는 아니고 조절하다는 뜻으로 쓰였습니다. 발음 연습도 해보죠.
manageable, manageable, manageable. And lastly, we have regulate, regulate, regulate. Perfect. How about we take a look at the clip once again, but with English subtitles.
In this day and age, people feel so compelled to say yes to every single opportunity that they're given. And while that's a good thing, being open-minded and wanting to say yes, I also think that it's okay to say no sometimes for your own mental health. Because if you are always overbooking everything and just trying to take every opportunity you can, it can be mentally tiring and you end up getting burnt out. I see that with a lot of my friends who make online videos, that they just put way too much on their plate and get overwhelmed and then sort of end up just stopping and doing nothing for a little while. And so for me personally, instead of that, I think it's better to take things at a manageable pace and try and sort of regulate it so you can always do it. And that means sometimes you have to say no to stuff, and that's okay.